Malachi 1:1, it says, the burden of the word of the Lord to Israel by Malachi. I have loved you, saith the Lord, yet ye say, wherein hast thou loved us? Was not Esau Jacob's brother, saith the Lord? All right, so basically through the Spirit, the Heavenly Father is letting it be known to Malachi that the Heavenly Father loved them, all right, by way of going back to Jacob and Esau, right, which Jacob and Esau were the last division of the nations, right, in terms of the covenant, where it was established that Jacob's children, which Jacob got his name changed to Israel, and his children took on that name, all right, being the Israelites, all right, so saying, it says, was not Esau Jacob's brother, saith the Lord, yeah, I love Jacob, right, so he loved Jacob, and the reason why he loved Jacob is because Jacob bore the name of the Heavenly Father, and in bearing the name of the Heavenly Father, they also bear his covenant, right, and that love was established upon them, whereby when you go into the covenant, it tells you in the book of Deuteronomy, the 28th chapter, where it was established that basically, look, you follow according to these laws, if you uphold your side of the bargain, I'm going to uphold mine, in right, in a sense, to bless you, and for you to be able to go forth and be able to have no enemies. It didn't say the world would be at peace, it said you will have no enemies, alright? Safety will dwell within your land, right? Because a lot of people get the Bible messed up, alright? Basically, it was peace for the Israelites, alright? Because that was the covenant was established with them. But then when you go on to verse 15 and you read down, basically what it speaks about is the curses that will come upon the children of Israel, alright? Which we're basically dealing with right now. That's why the so-called Negroes, Hispanics, Native Americans are looked at basically the bottom of society. That's the Lord keep upholding his side of the bargain in terms of the curses that he placed upon us. Alright, so Malachi 1:3. So it says, and I hated Esau and laid his mountains and his heritage waste for the dragons of the wilderness. Alright, and when did that happen? That happened going back to the Roman, when the fall of the Roman Empire, okay? The pagan Roman Empire. Before the coming in of the Holy Roman Empire, where you basically had Jake take over and establish a rulership, where we basically, the prophecy in the book of Revelations, the book of Revelations, we're basically prophesied that the dragon will be sealed up for 1,000 years, will come into play, all right? And when it happened, you'd have the rulers over the earth being so-called Negroes dealing with Europe, right, where we basically had dominion over that land. That's why it was known as the Dark Ages or the Middle Ages, all right? Known as the Dark Ages because, hey, the so-called white man, the Edomites, were in darkness, all right? They were basically banished to the caves. And that's why it says their mount, this is really going to come to pass in the times we're in, right? But they were basically in the mountains and all that type of stuff. But it's also known as the Middle Ages, because we bear rule, and after what comes after the middle? If you have a beginning and then you have a middle, what happens? You have an end, all right? We're in the end ages, basically, all right? And all you gotta do is read the book of Second Esdras, basically, because he goes into it, all right? The angel that comes before him and basically gives him the tokens to understand what's gonna happen in the future, basically lets him know that the earth is heading into the end, all right? That it's split up into 12 parts. The last two parts will come into play. But anyway, let me read on. So it says, verse 3, it says, and I hated Esau and laid his mountains and his heritage waste for the dragons of the wilderness. Whereas Edom saith, we are impoverished, but we will return and build desolate places. Alright? And that's the time that we're basically in right now. Esau's return and built up desolate places. Even where I'm at right now, this is basically one of the unclean frogs spoke of in the book of Revelations, the 8th chapter, alright? Being known as the City of London, okay? Which is known as the financial district over out of the free district, free unclean frogs of Esau, alright? The first one being Washington DC or District of Columbia, which basically is the warfare arm, the arm of war, the city city of war, basically. Then you have the city of London, which is a financial district. But then you also have the Vatican City, right, which is known as a religious city. So those are the three unclean frogs. And through those three unclean frogs, they basically go forth and present parts of Esau's spirit, okay? So Rina again says, whereas Edom said, we are impoverished, but we'll return and build desolate places, all right? And that's what they've done. That's where we're presently in. Thus saith the Lord of hosts, they shall build, but I will throw down, all right? And what did I read in the book of Ecclesiastes, the third chapter? It's Solomon spoke of a time to build and a time to break down, all right? So we're basically in a time where everything's being built and established. And even right now, they're still building, because what do they want to do? We're in a time of the new normal, right? And a great reset, right? These things are basically the establishment of the capstone of Esau's rulership, dealing with the Illuminati, right? Where they basically want to bring their new order into its final form, basically, right? So let me read that again. So it says, whereas Edom saith, we are impoverished, but we will return and build desolate places. And that was them coming out of the cave, okay? They came out of the cave and they basically established themselves again. It says, thus saith the Lord of hosts, they shall build, but I will throw down, right? So basically, that's Job, the book of Job, the 20th chapter, where basically it says that when he's about to fill his belly, then shall sudden destruction come, right? Because basically, when they're in the midst of building and establishing their power, that's when the Heavenly Father will bring it to an end. By way of World War III, Iraq, which we're in the midst of as well, okay? Which I'll touch on in a moment. But it says, and they shall call them the border of wickedness. And this is the reason why I read this, right? So it says, and they shall call them the border of wickedness, and the people against whom the Lord Yahweh have indignation forever, all right? So they're being established to be the border of wickedness. So wherever Esau, Edom presents themselves and establishes and builds that their new stronghold, basically, they'll be known as the borders of wickedness, right? So that lets you know where we're at. So let me go back to the book of Jeremiah 28. So in layman's terms, hey, Esau, Edom, who's today known as the so-called white man or the Caucasian, themselves to escape from their true nationality, they're basically ruling the world right now, all right? And the prophets of Yahweh, Baal Shem, Yahweh Shai, headed by a great millstone, all right? But then also you got different brothers out there that are teaching the right doctrine. They're basically being risen up by their spirit and power of Yahweh, Baal Shem, Yahweh Shai, to prophesy the downfall of this kingdom, all right? So it's the book of Jeremiah 28:8 says, the prophets that have been before me and before thee of old prophesied both against many countries and against great kingdoms of war and of evil and of pestilence, alright? Now we're in the midst of war and evil, but we're in the midst, what speaks volumes as to this book being a living book is the fact that we're in the midst of a pestilence, alright? Pestilence is basically plagues. Alright, the plague, as you know, that we know, you know, hanging the basically the crown, alright, we're in the midst of that right now, alright, and now what they've come out this week, it's come out, and this is a silly thing, it's only come out, they're saying there's new mutations, new variants or whatever, but the reality is that there's been variants, guys. They said there was 22 variants or so, 20 plus variants back in Wuhan, alright, they spoke about it. They actually spoke of it and said that there was variants back then. So now, due to what you gotta understand is with Esau, he's wiser than Daniel, man. He's doing things by choice, right? And really, obviously, through the spirit and power and the will of the Heavenly Father. But he utilizes subtlety, all right? right? Remember, this is saying we're dealing with the same spirit that was in the garden, Adam and Eve, right? That showed great subtlety. So basically, he's known that these variants was around from before, a long time ago, and it was made known, right? Well, this guy is one that even through my why I believe, right, is that he knew about all these variants. This is something he utilized to basically get all the people on the back foot to establish a new world order, right? But now they're coming out and they're saying that they got a new mutation out, right? And then you've had the government basically trying to establish confidence in the people by saying that the vaccinations that they basically spoke of still work with the different variants that are out there. But mind you, that's the government saying that, all right? These companies didn't come out and say that. Because if you do your Googles and you look into it, what you'll find out is that the vaccinations that the companies like Pfizer, Moderna, all right, all these different companies, they came out and they said they're gonna start doing testing with the new variants against the blood samples that they have of the people that have been inoculated, all right? So they don't even know if these variants will work with each other. But the reason why they're doing it, they're kicking the can down the road to basically get the most out of the people. Remember, this is a power play that's going on right now, right? And I always use the example, I've been steady on this example, because we're in spiritual Sodom in Egypt, all right?